In an effort to maximize an individual's comprehension of job safe practices, Kaiser Trentwood has begun transforming written job safe practices to the video medium. The use of personal protective equipment is featured as an integral part of these video job safe practices. The initial step in converting the written JSPs to video is to sequence the job steps, identify the hazards, and video each step, emphasizing the potential for injury. The next step is to begin assembling the footage. The digital effects processor enables the viewer to closer identify with the hazard, or the potential of the hazard. Many concepts can be conveyed to the viewer, such as the dangers of inattention or daydreams in the workplace. Simple, everyday routines are emphasized to help alleviate complacency and to remind us of the little things that become easily forgotten. We believe that the utilization of actual operators, machines, and areas produces an effective job-safe practice training tool. It is our hope the new as well as the experienced employee will enjoy a heightened awareness of the hazards inherent to their jobs. This is the job safe practice for the Alliance Crane. This video JSP is intended for use as a supplement to the written job safe practices. If you should encounter this sign at the base of the spiral stairs leading to the Alliance Crane, this is an indication that the crane is out of service and work is being performed. Contact 132 Mill Foreman. When entering or leaving crane, use the handrails, check steps, make sure they are clean and oil-free. Also, inspect handrails for broken welds. The landing seems to be a catch-all for everything. Take time to clean. Place equipment in the proper location to avoid stumbling hazards. Be sure all controls are in neutral position before throwing main boarding switch. Test the trolley and bridge brakes before proceeding. It is wise to check the horn, making sure it is functional in case of an emergency. Form a habit of paying close attention to the tong pressure indicator light as well as all illuminated control devices. If not operating, they must be repaired at once. Examine.
When changing trays on the small slitters, remember to always stay below slitter hot rails. Watch for pedestrian and truck traffic in main aisle way. Ensure grab is clear of slitter rails before raising. Transferring jumbo trays on the south side is a tight working area. Be cautious. Watch for clearance. Trays must be secured properly in grab to prevent this from happening. Accidents such as this should be reported immediately to maintenance. Do not move crane until fully checked out for safe crane conditions. Tag out unsafe trays. Damaged trays are a safety hazard for everyone involved.
This is the job safe practice for the scalper saw operator. This video JSP is intended for use as a supplement to the written job safe practice. Inspect the crane at the start of each shift for the following. Make sure the controls function properly and the power cord is secure and glides freely. Note the condition of the cables. It is critical that the Youngstown is suspended correctly. If the hoist brake does not hold under a load, maintenance should be contacted. Inspect the hook for cracks. Do not operate the crane if the safety latch is broken or missing. Thoroughly check the Heppenstall tong assembly. Make sure it is in good working order and the points are secure. Check the travel of the bridge and the trolley. Before starting the scalper, be aware of personnel in the area. Like all machinery, know where your emergency stops are located. This could prevent a serious injury. Use caution at all times. Keep the crane a safe distance from the load arm when loading the scalper. Check the ingot, making sure it is well secured and against the stops. To prevent burns or loss of your eyesight, do not operate the scalper with a defective chip guard. With the presence of airborne particles and hot flying chips, your safety glasses are invaluable in this environment. Never turn your back to the scalper when an ingot is being unloaded or turned in the automatic mode. If you're not sure which alloys should be preheated, refer to the written JSPs. Metal must be marked with a pH if it has been preheated. During extremely cold weather, ingots must be stored inside for a minimum of 2 hours or more to prevent coolant from freezing on the ingots, creating a very hazardous situation. Treat all ingots as if they were hot. If you can't hold your bare hand on any ingot, do not attempt to scalp them. Always be alert for trucks servicing the scalper. Never stand in front of or turn your back to the trucks bringing in a load of ingots. Under no circumstances should you subject yourself to injury by positioning yourself under the crane, loaded or unloaded. Do not allow truckers to stack ingots so high that you can't unload them in a safe manner. Keep from walking between stacks. It is a definite pinch point and metal can be extremely sharp. Hydraulics must be off and the scalper in manual before changing stops. Electrical and hydraulic mechanisms can falter, engaging machinery at a most unlikely time. Never place an ingot in loading position when stops are to be changed. Always wear gloves to protect yourself from slivers and cuts while handling wood products and metal with sharp edges. Do not accept or send out unsafe stacks. Caution must be taken when covering scalped ingots with cardboard and 4x6s. Mobile equipment is always present in this area. All tools, trash, spare parts, and wooden spacers must be picked up at all times. Scrap chips have a tendency to build up quite rapidly, causing a slipping hazard. Area should be cleaned at least once a shift and duct boards kept in good repair. Watch out for oil and coolant on the floors. Numerous stumbling hazards such as ingot stops, abrupt edges on duct boards, holes in the floor, and protruding bunks can cause a serious fall. Cleaning the scalper can be done in a safe manner by following three simple steps. Put the scalper in the manual mode. Lower hydraulic clamps. Start the traverse. Never attempt to clean the scalper with an ingot in the machine. Imagine what could happen if the hydraulics failed. When leaving the area for any reason, be sure the hoist is raised to its upper limits and the power is off to the crane. Before operation of the scalper begins, make sure the area is clear of personnel. Also, you need constant communication with crew members concerning operation. Number 4 scalper is totally automated with built-in safety devices. Even with these safeguards, it is far from being fail-safe. Before starting your daily operation, inspect the crane. With the weight capacity that the crane handles, cables and turnbuckles are subject to great stress. Be observant for wear on the power supply cord due to the continuous movement of the crane. A watchful eye should be kept on the Youngstown to prevent serious damage to the crane or worse, injury to yourself or others. Make sure that the clamps are working freely and not binding. Check jaws for any broken, damaged, or loose parts on the crane. Stay alert. Make sure the crane doesn't raise an ingot until the green light appears. Regardless of warning signs, some personnel have a tendency of entering restricted areas. Insist that this practice be stopped. Be knowledgeable of all emergency stop locations in the scalper area. In the event of a crisis, the crane or scalper could be stopped immediately. Disable auto crane whenever leaving the pulpit. The crane could malfunction, causing serious injury to you or your co-workers. To avoid back strain, lift properly and wear gloves. Stay alert for approaching mobile equipment. The crane has built-in safety devices designed to disable the crane if personnel enter restricted area. As you leave the pulpit to write down CDIs, remember to deactivate the crane. Tripping hazards such as 4x4s, bunks, oily surfaces, and cords or hoses are always present. You could fall onto an ingot that has a sharp edge or points. Keep stairs and work areas clean. When you are confronted by this sign, stop. This lets you know that the scalper is being worked on. Do not confuse this sign with a lockout. Never start the scalper until maintenance has relinquished the scalper to production. Heed all alarms, signals, and warning signs. Ingot plate saw. Perform a general inspection of the crane as done on number 2 scalper. Test the vacuum lift prior to use. Lift the ingot 2 inches off the bunk. Turn the vacuum lift power off. Cups must hold the ingot for 2 minutes. If not, check cups, hoses, and valves for leaks. If the problem still exists, contact maintenance. Changing from the Vaculift to the HEP installed tongs exposes many pinch points. Be careful. The saw area is extremely slick due to hydraulic fluid and coolant on the floor. You have a very limited work area. There are many tripping hazards. Hoses, saw chips, bunks, and ingots. You are put in an awkward position at times. Maintain a clean work area. Store equipment and supplies in an orderly fashion. Keep an open access to the emergency stop button or switches. Be extremely careful when setting up the saw. The most common injury has been attributed to pinch points. When removing pins, the pry bar can slip, causing the operator to smash his or her hands. This also applies when ratcheting the clamps. Make sure all materials are clamped properly. Tables and stairs are extremely slippy. Travel with caution. While the saw is in operation, maintain a safe distance to avoid being struck by flying saw chips. Never make any adjustment while the saw is running. Wait until the saw comes to a complete stop. When removing end pieces, caution must be taken. The ingot may catch and swing towards you. Take time. Think safety.